Welcome back to Pinnacle FC 7. It's co-main event time. Kama, the Death Star Worthy, taking on Anthony Morgan. And Kyle, let's start with you. We're looking at the keys to victory here. What does Kama Worthy have to do to move that to 6-2?
Key number one is change the tempo. Kama is very good and very adept at taking the distance away or creating it whenever he wants to, and he needs to continue to do that. If he doesn't like the way an opponent's moving, he told us on the show Wednesday in the Coyote Ugly Show, he'll straight up just stop. Number two is dancing feet, and those two kind of coincide together. He needs to keep on his balls of his feet, keep moving off of his heels, and just continue lateral movement to create those kind of angles for the traditional style and background that he has in his stand-up. And last but not least is counter the right hand. Morgan, the spoiler, will be looking to throw it, and Kama needs to use that distance and that timing that he possesses in order to turn the tides.
And Dave, his opponent Anthony Morgan, how does he get it done and pull off another upset here in Pittsburgh?
Yeah, one of his biggest goals is to immediately take the center of the cage. As, you know, he kind of claims the cage in that way. Number two, he needs to close the distance. Kama's going to want to stay on the outside, but Morgan loves to throw short inside punches. Number three, he needs to keep his hands high in this one. Kama is going to be trying to kick his head off, punch his head off, do everything to him, but he needs to keep his hands high, especially on kicks and punches.
It's a contrast of styles. Anthony Morgan is a decision machine. Kama Worthy thinks the referee's only in the ring to save one of them. Let's bring out the first fighter and get our co-main event underway.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back. Pittsburgh, are you ready? It is time for your co-main event of the night. And it takes place in the Pinnacle Fighting Championships Professional Featherweight Division. It is brought to you by the Unseen Armada. Check out their latest in t-shirts and fightwear tonight. Let's bring them out. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the Pinnacle Cage, Anthony Morgan.
Anthony Morgan from Tennessee, representing the Fit Factory MMA, 23 years old. Nicknamed the Spoiler because he consistently travels out of town and knocks off the hometown favorite. He looks to do that again here tonight, Dave.
Yeah, he's a very straightforward fighter, loves to do things the right way. Very, you know, I call him vanilla, but that's not necessarily a bad thing because he does things the right way, does really great 1-2 combination, throws great kicks, and it's really can be aggressive at times too.
Interesting coming into the fight, Dave, to follow up on what you said. He has a conservative approach. He said mistakes get you knocked out. He's not going to look, he looks not to make mistakes, and he embraces the grind. Kyle, I call him a decision machine. He thinks that you have 15 minutes in the fight to work, and he wants to use them all.
Well, he's going to find difficulty getting all 15 of those minutes with Kama the Death Star Worthy in there. Kama has made his name on taking people out and taking them out early in devastating fashion. And this is going to be no different in his game plan. He's going to come right at Morgan and look to end it early.
Morgan, a man who's never been finished, enters the cage. We send it back up to Jazz to bring out his opponent.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's bring his opponent to the cage. Please welcome Kama Worthy.
To say Kama Worthy is a veteran of Pinnacle would be a massive understatement. This is Pinnacle's seventh card. This is Kama Worthy's sixth fight under the Pinnacle banner. He's also from Fight Club Pittsburgh, which makes him quite popular. Let's take a look at the tail of the tape, Kyle. What stands out to you?
Immediately, it's gonna have to be the height. Now, while it's only 1 inch difference vertically, I guarantee you Kama is gonna have some longer arms in this fight and is gonna use that distance in his jab. Morgan is 145 pounds, Kama Worthy 146. 27 years old Worthy, 23 years old Morgan, both men at 5-2. Pretty much even across the board besides maybe that length, Ryan.
Dave, you spent quite a bit of time this week talking with Kama Worthy. He seems mentally in the right place coming into this fight.
Exactly, yeah. He knows that he needs to get a knockout here, but he says he's going to knock him out because he wants a main event fight for an upcoming Pinnacle card.
He's had some big words for Morgan, and not disrespectful, just honest. He said that Morgan's a tough fighter, but he's also an easy fighter. He says he always stays in second gear, meaning Morgan, and Kama Worthy says nobody changes pace like him in the fight. He's gonna push the tempo, he's gonna bring it back, and he's gonna keep Anthony Morgan guessing.
Yeah, that's huge. And, of course, his only two losses to a guy who are now a combined 11-1 overall. So not a huge mark on his record, but, you know, lost to two tough guys. Now coming in on a four-fight win streak.
Winner of 5 of 6, Kama Worthy, gets himself pumped up as he enters the cage. It's time for the official introductions for our co-main event, Jazz Sakuro. Take it away.
Ladies and gentlemen, hang on to something. Here we go. It is time for your co-main event of the evening. It is brought to you by the Unseen Armada. 3 rounds in the Pinnacle Fighting Championships Professional Featherweight Division. And now, introducing, fighting out of the blue corner, his record sits with 5 wins versus 2 defeats. He stands 5 feet 10 inches tall and weighed in at an even 145 pounds. He represents Fit Factory and fights out of Sevierville, Tennessee. Here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, Anthony the Spoiler Morgan. And now his opponent across the Pinnacle cage, standing on my left, fighting out of the red corner. His record is also 5 victories versus 2 defeats. He is currently riding a 5-4 fight win streak. He stands 5 feet 11 inches tall. He weighed in at an even 146 pounds. He represents Fight Club Pittsburgh, fighting out of the Steel Town of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Presenting Kama, the Death Star. Your referee in charge is William Bookwalter.
As only Jazz Sakuro can do it, getting us ready for the co-main event.
The Pinnacle Fighting Championships co-main event. We've been over our instructions and our bout conduct in the back. Protect yourself at all times, obey my commands at all times. If you want to touch gloves, do so now. When the bell rings, you're fighting.
Final instructions from Bill Bookwalter. It's Kama Worthy in the short spandex trunks. Anthony Morgan, long fight shorts. Ryan Kavanaugh with David McKinney, Kyle, the Coyote, Rozeski. It's co-main event time, featherweight division.
Both men immediately take the middle of the cage. Kama with a nice jab, 1-2 from Morgan.
Morgan snaps off that combination in return.
Morgan's hand's already going down low.
Inside kick, but Morgan checks it. And Morgan looks to be, I'm impressed with the hand speed on the counters. Kama playing that little rope dope in and out.
Good head movement though by Morgan, just inches away from eating jabs.
Kama tough to hit.
You know, Kama said that Morgan's a fighter who stays in second gear, but so far his hand speed, second gear is pretty good because he looks very quick with his hands.
He just missed on a big looping right hand.
And Morgan, not a guy afraid to stand 15 minutes. His last fight, he stood 15 minutes with another very unorthodox striker in Chris Wright. Picking up the win there.
Kama going to the feints early, moving his hands. But you know, that may happen with a lesser skilled fighter, but Anthony Morgan is a veteran. He shoots in for the takedown. Kama defending.
Nice takedown defense.
Looking
here
for that double leg, switching over to a single, maybe a crotch lift now. But Kama doing an excellent job of takedown defense.
Morgan looking to clasp his hands, and he does.
Oh,
nice
great
trip.
Great little knee in the face of Kama Worthy, and then a nice backside trip by Morgan, who's on top now on Kama's half guard.
And this is the grind that Morgan is so good at.
Kama on his hip here, looking to get out the back door.
And it's amazing to hear how quiet this building has gotten now that Kama's on his back.
Absolutely. You know, Kama Worthy says fighting is poetry, and he really displays the beauty of it. Anthony Morgan wants to make this a dirty fight. He wants to make it an ugly fight, and that's no disrespect. That's what we're seeing right here.
Absolutely.
This is Anthony Morgan all over Kama Worthy.
Worthy back up here.
Good scramble by Kama to get back to his feet. And she's knees soon. Oh, big
nice
right elbow
right
by Morgan.
Big right, absolutely, on the clinch. And then Morgan goes right back in for the shot.
I think you're right, Ryan. This is the fight that he's looking to make.
Worthy has
he's trying to drag
here.
This out. That's going to be
looks
tough
like
to finish
tight
from that angle.
Is Morgan in any danger here?
Yeah, he wasn't there. I think he was actually working to go.
Kama, nice sweep.
Oh,
butterfly
great
sweep.
Great sweep by Worthy. Now he's in danger, Ryan. Before, I think Morgan may have even been going for a counter choke on that.
But Morgan gets up. Kama going for the wrist, but
Morgan now looking for the single leg.
Morgan looking for a crotch lift here again. He might switch to a single here. His head is on the inside, so if he pops that left leg outside like he's trying to do there, he could wheel around. Like, yep, he is definitely going for the single leg. Kama looks to be trying to get a Kimura.
See, Pinnacle owner Matt Layshock in the back getting a nice look at the action here. What a card he's put on once again. and it's Anthony Morgan. Great takedown defense.
Nice.
Kama Worthy.
Excellent that job. And great job at striking on disengagement.
Using that Kimura.
3 minutes gone in the first round. 3 5-minute rounds.
Kama now stalking. Big right hand.
And Morgan now backing up a little bit more. Kama coming forward.
Be interesting to see if Kama keeps the game plan together, because right now.
Nice.
Oh, big oh. left hand by Kama Worthy, and he drops Anthony Morgan.
Morgan, though, seems to be resilient and has recovered already, shooting for a double grinding on the cage. We don't know how hard he is.
Good head position here from Morgan against the cage.
But there's a glimpse of what Kama brings to the table. Huge
he
left hand.
Is so explosive.
Kama back to his feet already.
Another takedown, but Kama back up.
Good body shot by Kama Worthy. Anthony Morgan staying chest to chest, keeping tight, not letting Kama get loose with those hands.
There's a good knee there by Kama. He's trying to get some space between his hips and Morgan's to throw some more knees, or just at least turn into him.
And a good battle here between both guys. Both guys doing a little bit of what they want in the first round.
Morgan throws some left knees to the body. Oh, just Kama like that, Kama does it.
Kama.
Oh, with another a full tie knee. Clinch.
Another big knee there. Come with it.
It is very evident Morgan desperately wants this fight in the ground now.
Good
but I think we
defense.
Knew that would happen as soon as he felt the power of Kama Worthy, both from the hands and the knees.
Kama
and
with
see,
a knee against the cage there.
Well, he seemed very content to stand and bang with Kama until I believe that last left hook that stunned him. And now Morgan is definitely making the grind out of this, and it's going to be a tough to score this round if it continues this way.
Kyle, which fighters is wearing out more from this action?
Right now, Morgan is laying all of his body weight from the shoulder pressure on the diaphragm of one Kama Worthy, not allowing his lungs to expand fully. So
but
definitely Kama's bracing the weight.
But is Morgan expending more energy to do this?
No, you can use gravity in your own body weight, really, essentially,
that's
if
me.
You just push with their calves a little bit.
15 seconds in the first round, Morgan working for the takedown. Great sprawl
Kama
by Kama.
Oh, nice knee.
And another knee.
Up.
He's pouring it on.
There's that tempo change from Kama Worthy.
I think Kama just looked up at the clock.
And that's the end of round one. What an action-packed 5 minutes.
Excellent pace. These two are bringing it.
Dave McKinney, I throw it to you first. How do you score the first round?
Tough. I mean, based on overall damage, I'd have to give it to Kama Worthy. Anthony Morgan with some great positioning there, but based on damage, if you're scoring damage, then I got to give it to Kama Worthy.
Kyle.
On that criteria, I'd have to agree.
And there you go.
If we were going on control, Morgan would have to be the victor in that round. But again, the fights are based on damage, and I would go with Kama Worthy.
It's going to be interesting to see how the judges scored that as we momentarily had a look at the Pinnacle FC Dream Girls. It is co-main event time, and he's certainly got the spark, and you can see that Kama Worthy is obviously the fan favorite as we take a look at the replay from the first round.
There's that big left hand that dropped Morgan.
It definitely did drop him, but it dropped him conveniently into a double leg position.
And as I mentioned, as you pointed out in that first round, Kyle, that you know that you can tell how Kama Worthy is doing by the audience and the crowd and the noise.
Absolutely, the volume tells the tale.
Round two, Kama Death Star Worthy, Anthony Spoiler Morgan. A very close first round.
And here we go, round two, the fighters touch gloves.
Kama Worthy takes center cage. And Kama, notice the footwork, staying to the outside of the right hand of Anthony Morgan.
Both fighters have their elbows in. Very good stand-up technique.
And then Morgan with the looping left almost connects.
And this is that speed change Kama was talking about. He ended the first round aggressively, and now he's kind of settling back and countering.
Superman punch there from Morgan.
And I like what Kama's doing. He's coming out and establishing that jab. He's keeping Morgan at distance, and he's also scoring points, finding a home for that jab.
I'm a big fan of the way Morgan's moving laterally as well. One thing I want to see him do differently is move his left foot first when he moves left. You see, he steps his right foot behind. I think Kama's going to catch him.
There's a nice three-piece by Kama, right to the body, left to the face.
Morgan missing.
And right now, Morgan is not, he's not closing the range to connect with Worthy, and Kama's counter-punching and landing.
And I think every punch Kama lands, his confidence is growing, and you can see it.
Kama's going to connect on one of these uppercuts. He's swimming with his punches, but Morgan leaving his head out there exposed because he's overextending and missing with that right hook.
Morgan has a tendency to drop his hands. We saw this fight Antonio Castillo. The beginning of every round he got hit, then put flat on his back. Of course, that's not Kama's game plan here.
But outside leg kick by Kama Worthy. Kama Worthy, the confidence is growing.
Kama throwing combination there. Definitely looks like Kama's in his groove here now. And Morgan just can't hit him, and Kama telling him to come on.
Showmanship from Kama Worthy, waving Anthony Morgan on. There's the confidence growing, and there's the left jab from Kama. Stiff left to the face of Morgan.
And honestly, I have to wonder if this doesn't play into Morgan's benefit. I think this is the type of fight that he likes. I think he is that kind of guy that you wave in, and it's only going to fire him up.
Morgan crossing his feet there.
There's a small mouse under the right eye of Anthony Morgan.
Oh, ate a big knee.
Big knee. And Morgan answers with one of his own, but Kama Worthy's found a home in the tie clinch with those knees. He backs Morgan
nice
up against
there.
The defense. Absolutely, Dave. Nice jab. And this is almost a Diaz brothers type fight.
Nice left hand.
Where Worthy's not hitting him with power shots, but he's hitting him with a lot of shots. Another jab.
The CompuBox is blowing up right now.
And Worthy showing Anthony Morgan, he hit him on his elbow.
And Worthy now is...
Worthy took a shot there.
Well, he connected, and you know he connected because Worthy waved him on with both hands. That's how you know a fighter got hit. There's the jab again. The jab again. Worthy tenderizing the face of Morgan with that left jab.
I don't think it's the taunting antics of Worthy that's going to bother Morgan so much as that jab. Again, Morgan is a mentally tough guy who doesn't really knock anybody out.
But his gas is running down. He doesn't have the power to stay tight and continue to grind for that takedown.
You hear Bob Meese in the corner. Screaming at Kama Worthy, breathe.
Oh, big uppercut.
Both guys just tee off there.
Morgan with a big uppercut, caught Kama's attention, but he looks to have shrugged it off. Reminder, Morgan is a dangerous fighter on the feet as well.
And he's continuing that right behind left step that I'm really starting to get worried about here. I think Kama is gonna eventually catch on to that. Maybe a rear leg head kick.
Good stand-up battle here. Looks like Morgan pretty much given up on the takedown here in the second round.
Kama Worthy's done a nice job. Head kick by Morgan. Not a whole lot of steam on that, though, and a teep from Kama Worthy.
I'm expecting Kama to answer that head kick back pretty soon. Oh, big left uppercut.
Body shot and a left hook from Worthy. Kama's putting it all together now.
Looks like Morgan busted open under his eye now.
Yeah, Matt, he's starting to pepper up Anthony Morgan here.
Yeah, I believe that mouse under the right eye has now exploded. Worthy again, waving him on, trying to bait him into the stand-up war that he's having right now. There's Worthy moving out of the way, connecting with the left.
Great footwork here from Kama.
Morgan would actually be better off if that cut, or if that did end up cutting and opening up. He's starting to swell up pretty badly under that eye.
Kama completely focused here.
Oh!
Big left by Morgan.
A looping left hook as Kama threw a teep. Morgan right here needs to present a threat to Kama. Kama is just stalking him down without any kind of resistance.
You can see Morgan trying to push away that jab from Kama. Might see him come over the top here with the right hand.
Leg kick by Morgan, and he gets a big left from Kama in return. And he's hurt for him. And Kama Worthy's all over him. Oh. Kama Worthy hits the off switch on Anthony Morgan. Knockout Kama Worthy.
Tempo change.
There is the tempo change. It got really quick, and then it stopped abruptly.
He went from 0 to 150 there.
And Kama is climbing the cage in front of us here, showing some air guitar, I think. And he's loving life right now.
Always the showman. We'll have to see.
Worthy put it together in that second round. The tempo change was a constant jab and an increase until he finally hit him with his power. We'll take a look at how this went down.
Kama lulling him to sleep a little bit here, just kind of, you know, one twos here, and then really just exploding to that jab.
And here comes the combination that ends the night for Anthony Morgan.
The left, feint on the right. I think he loads up the hook here. Puts his right shoulder forward. And what might be the longest grass replay in history.
Right.
That's right, though. It's always a pleasure to watch Kama do some work. I think here's the end.
Left hand.
Yep, there's that left that started it. Kick. And here he loads it up. Yep, that hook right there, he loaded up.
Yeah.
That was the first one that did it. And you can see the shoulder really come forward. Then he exploded. And then it was just a left, right until the drop in front of you.
Impressive barrage. You know, you saw that coming. You saw it building. Kama Worthy found his range. He found his confidence, and it was a matter of time. Credit Anthony Morgan for taking a pounding in that second round, lasting as long as he did.
I have to give it to his constitution, if nothing else. I mean, that's very frustrating to get jabbed every time you make a motion. It just inhibits everything that you do, and you don't want to commit to anything, and then you start getting stifled in your offense. I think we saw that a little bit toward the end, but he did just such a great job of keeping his composure the entire time.
Very impressive, and this was a performance Kama Worthy wanted to put on. It was very important for him, not only to win, but to be placed at the top of the card. He wants a main event in Pinnacle. I'll be interested to see if he asked Dave Quick for it here after the fight. This, you know, for a fighter like Worthy, who's been such a staple in the organization, been really one of the top guys in Pinnacle, I think he's done enough to get top billing on one of these cards.
It's hard to argue that point. I mean, you heard the crowd tonight, you've seen his performance, his last few fights, you've all been witness to his last few performances, and nothing short of impressive and deserving.
Yeah, these sort of performances make doubters fans of yours. Kama Worthy moves to 6-2, winner of 6 of the last 7. And this is quite a career roll Kama Worthy's on.
And like we said, he wanted to join his teammates Mark Jericho, Cody Garbrandt, and getting some of that national love. Of course, you saw him after his last fight on Inside MMA. Now I'm sure he's going to get some more love after this win.
We set it up to Jazz to make our co-main event official. Jazz, take it away.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee William Bookwalter has seen enough and has stopped this fight at 4 minutes and 52 seconds of round number 2. Officially, this is a TKO due to strikes. Your winner,
Kama, the Death Star Worthy! All right, let's give it up from Anthony Morgan from the Fit Factory from Tennessee. Came here from Tennessee to take this fight. This man is a warrior, Anthony Morgan. All right, and I'm here with Pinnacle Fighting Championships veteran, Kama, the Death Star Worthy. He came out here like he always does. He's apologizing because he couldn't fully extend that right arm, but I'm very happy with the performance that he put on tonight. He's stressing a little bit because he can't find his banner to thank all his sponsors. But this guy always gives a great interview. So I'm going to give the microphone to him. Keep your eye on this guy. This man is a warrior. He brings it to the cage every single time. He is Kama Worthy, and here he is.
Hey, man, thanks, Clint. Been honored working with you for a long time. I just want to thank all the fans, man, for coming out here, seriously. This is your holiday weekend. Y'all paying $85 a ticket to come watch us chase our dreams and everybody everywhere else all over the place. I want to thank you guys, seriously. There's the camera. All right, I'm all looking all over. I want to thank all of my training partners down at the Fight Club, everybody, all of my coaches. My boxing coach, Bob Meese, man, that dude's a scientist. Anthony Darnell, my Muay Thai coach. Lou, my jiu-jitsu coach. I've been working with Mark Angle on my wrestling, man. That's been phenomenal. I want to thank my head coach, Master White Fang, AKA Dan. I want to thank all of my sponsors, JM Roofing, Lil Bruiser Fight Gear. They have stuff all over here. Pittsburgh Kettlebell and Performance, Reaction Nutrition, Intimidation. Who else? Cordova, definitely. Mario's Pizza. Who else is on my butt? Oh, yeah, now also I'm out of the cage as well. Hey, man, go over there and buy my T-shirt. They have them over there at the Little Bruiser standing out of the cage, man. I could use the money. I work like 3 jobs. I'm working hard. Go buy yourself a T-shirt. Hey, man, we're going up to Mario's Pizza right there on Green Tree. Grab some pizza. Rise, my boy Cody comes here doing his thing. Then the after party, if you're 21 and over, after party's down in the Southside Bar, 1311. I hope I didn't miss any of my sponsors. Oh, I want to thank my yoga instructors, Jessica Ray, for helping me get control of my breath, and my strength coach, Big John Lubavitch, because this here is no accident, baby. Thank you to everyone, all of my fans. You guys are amazing. So all of my fans, don't go nowhere. My boy Cody's about to come in here and handle his business. Thank you, everyone.
Who wants to see this guy in a Pinnacle main event? Soon.
It's main event time, baby. This is three co-main events, three knockouts, baby. I ain't flexing like this for nothing. It's main event time.
He's the Death Star. He is Kama, the Death Star, worthy.